This is Kirk and Cassius for IFL TV in association with Macklin Jamal. We're at the Echo Arena for Who's Fooling Who, making his professional debut tonight. Ryan Malachi.
Malachi.
I knew I was going to get it wrong. Early night's work. First round win over Ross Roberts. See that one coming?
Well, to be honest, everyone's been in my ear this week because obviously it was Ross's debut as well. We could have took easier fights, which were journeymen that we know about and stuff like that, but my manager picked him because they wanted me to show me skills off against someone who's going to actually come to win instead of come to like just get the rounds out. But unfortunately for Ross, it didn't last as long as hopefully, well, that he wanted it to either. But that's what happens in boxing.
That is what happens in boxing. Talk to me about the finish. What do you remember of it?
Well, I was just trying to find the range with my jab, and I was looking for the lean back right hand, to be honest. And he caught me with a jab and just woke me up straight away. And as soon as we engaged again, I fainted the jab just like we do in the gym. Short right hand and come over with the left hook and just put on the kip.
Right, that's an honest assessment. But it's very quite rare in the professional game that you get two pro debutants willing to face each other in the first fight. I mean, I don't remember the last time it was done, to be honest, but credit to the pair of you. But I'm sure Ross will obviously come back from that. But for you, it's a stunning start to your professional career.
Yeah, I couldn't have been better, to be honest. It might be my pro debut, but it's my 84th fight. It's the third time I've boxed in the Echo Arena. I just want to get up the ladder as fast as I can. It's pointless fighting journeymen who are going to hold you. That's why I'm still a bit frustrated now. I wanted to show my skills off, what I can do. Because I can do more than just knock people out. I can box and punish people over the rounds as well, which is what I want to do.
Will you start the weight that you fought tonight?
Light welter, yeah. Yeah, definitely. I've got good sparring in the gym at light welters who are bigger than me, so for now, I'm going to definitely stay at light welter, but I'm 23. I have a bit of growth spurt, I'll move up, but I want titles at light welter.
It's actually called super lightweight now.
I know, which is a bit more.
It's really confusing, and it's the American terminology creeping over here, but we know it as the 140 division. So.
Obviously, Matchroom put me down as a flyweight contest, and he spelt my name wrong, so hopefully they know.
What in the programme?
In the programme, put me down as a flyweight, and he spelt my name wrong on the door, but hopefully next time they know where I am.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
Dear. Now, I've just been obviously asked, I haven't been to your gym yet, but Robbie Davis Jr. is out of your gym.
Yeah.
Robbie. So what, because the hair obviously comes to mind, that is this a joke that you have in the gym with, you need to have the same hair? No, don't get it.
All Kirby had to like that.
Well, I'm not from Kirby, funny enough. I don't know why they announced me from Knowsley Vale. I'm actually from Anfield.
So they've got you completely wrong all the way on every aspect.
I box in Knowsley Vale as an amateur, but I'm from Anfield, North Liverpool, like originally, so everyone in the pool's got curly at the minute. I don't know what it is.
No, yeah,
don't know the trickly, but only Davey's baldy and the odd of this, but gotta look good on the camera.
Listen, as long as you're putting in forms like that, it doesn't matter what hair you got, so.
Yeah.
Listen, well done, and do you want to give a shout out?
Yeah, this is obviously for the young boxer, the boxer in my gym, and a good mate of mine, Vinnie Oligan. Yep. He passed away, tragically killed. That's for his family, and my sponsors, Fighting Demons, John, couldn't have done it without him. My nutritionist, Michael Malloy, and strength coach, and also my good friend Big John at Southwood Properties helped me out. So thanks for that. And Dave Tonks. John's
all right.
Everyone who bought a ticket, thanks. I had 200 tickets done there for my debut. I only used to have like 3 people watching me as an amateur, so it's good.
Was that these 3 as well? All right, thanks. Well, listen, well done tonight, and nice touch on the t-shirt.
Yeah.
And we will get down to your gym. It is one of the gyms we haven't actually been to, so.
Proper Scousers,
yeah,
man.
Proper Scousers.
Yeah.
Old Jacqueline,
yeah. 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 Right. That's untrue. All right, listen, Ron, thanks for talking to IFL TV, and I'm sure we'll catch up with you in the near future.
Yeah, thanks very much, Kieran.
All right.
Thank you.
Cheers, mate.
Thanks.